بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي Read Al-Quran the easy way. I welcome you to 22nd lesson in which we will study Sukoon. So get ready, take a deep breath, smile, charge your brain and turn off all the distractions like chat windows and mobiles and let's start. Start with signs rhyme. You know we studied Fatha, Kasra, Dhamma, standing Fatha, standing Kasra and inverted Dhamma. So we studied A, E, U. A, E, U. And we also have studied, Alif Mad, Ya Mad, Waw Mad, which makes the same sound as standing Fatha, standing Kasra, and inverted Dhamma like A, E, U. Before we go for other signs, let us take Sukoon. What is Sukoon? Sukoon sign is like a help sign. Therefore, letter with a Sukoon sign is helped by the one before it. Let's take the children's version here. Hamza and Meem, both with Fatha hat, go to park for swinging. So here they are, you know, Alif with Fatha means Hamza, so A and Ma are swinging. They are swinging, imagine they are swinging. And suddenly Meem fell down. Meem falls down. So what happened? The cap of Meem, which is Fatha, got damaged. It became Sukoon cap. It became twisted. It is as if Meem is telling that I need Sukoon because I'm hurt. I need rest. I need Sukoon. Sukoon means rest. Okay? That's one meaning. So, what happens? A comes down and helps Meem. The pair becomes Alright, so if you see the next letter with a sukoon, just help it. For example, A, and there's Meem with sukoon, A, there's Ba with sukoon, Ab. A, there's Fa with sukoon, Af. For practice, we have Alif with Fatha before every letter that we will do now. And the topic of sukoon is continued for the next 5 lessons to cover its different cases. Okay, how to spell it? Alif, Meem, Fatha. Alif Ba Fatha Ab Alif Fa Fatha Af. We don't need to spell every case, just look at the sukoon sign and merge it, help it. You know, you don't have to say all these steps except in, you know, challenging words, big words. Okay, what about sign of sukoon? Here are some tips. Actually, sign of sukoon is the letter Kha. Khalim min al haraka. That is without haraka. This letter does not have A, E, U. It is, you know, does not have any sign. That's why it is haraka sign. That's why it is khali, empty. Okay. And that is the head. And in those days, dots were not there when this sukoon sign was invented. So there you have the head of kha. Another way to look at it is, you know, look at this guy who is very tired, twisted. And that's the shape of the sukoon. It needs sukoon. It needs rest. Okay? Well, these are some of the tips for you to remember. Now, let's come back to letter poem and we will take only those words, those letters which we will cover in this lesson because there are other letters also with sukoon but they are special. So, we will cover them in the following lessons. So, here we are. Af. Ath. Ath. Av. 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 And then we have az. As. As, al, an, ar, and then we have aj, ash, ad, and then lastly we have ah, 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 ah. The rest will be covered later on, okay, in the following lessons. Let's practice 90 pairs of letters with a sukoon on the second letter. These pairs constitute almost 33% of total such occurrences in the Quran. The sukoon occurs almost on 60,000 letters of the Quran. So here are 90 pairs that represent 33% of total such occurrences of total 60,000. So just practice them thoroughly. Okay. So let's see the pair with lam. Here the second letter in all these cases, in the 10 words or 10 pairs that you see, the second letter in every case is lam with sukun. So you gotta help lam. So let's start. Hal. So ha is helping lam. Hal. Khal. Khal. Kha is high. Khal. Sal. Mul. Zal. Okay. The second one, second line. Qul. Al. Lil. Bal. Il. Okay, let's take the case with meem sukoon. The second letter in all these cases is a meem with a sukoon on it. So you've got to help meem in all these cases. Let's start. Hum. Kum. Him. Tum. Lam. Second line. Ham. Yam. Tam. Am. Kam. Let's take the third case here. The second letter in all these cases is noon with a sukoon on it. So we got to help noon in all these cases. Min. Man. In. An. Kun. That was the first line. Let's go to the second line now. In. Yan. Un. Tan. Lan. Very simple. I hope you don't find any problem. Those three, lam, mim, noon, are the most frequently occurring pairs with sukoon on the second letters. Let's take some more cases, like with fa. Naf. Yaf. Taf. Muf. Kuf. With seen. Yes. Tas. Is. Mus. Mas. With ayn. All these cases have the second letters with sukoon on them. So ayn with sukoon on them. Ba. Ya. Ta. Ni. Ma. With kha. Yakh. Takh. Ukh. Yukh. Mukh. Kha is high sounding. Okay, don't say yakh. Yakh. Takh. Ukh. Yukh. Mukh. Let's take with ra. Whenever ra is preceded by fatha or dhamma, you say it thick. Otherwise, it is thin. Fir. Qur. Yar. Mar. Qar. Okay, last four are thick. With dhal. Idh. Khadh. Tadh. Yadh. Yudh. With ha. Yah. Tah. Ah. Muh. Jah. And with ha. Tah. Yah. Rah. Ra is thick. Nah. Muh. And with ghain. Ghain is high sounding. Tog. Yog. Mag. Bag. Yog. And lastly, some miscellaneous cases, where we have different letters as second letters with sukoon on them. Mith. Yash. Riz. Fad. Yas. Fad is very thick and high, and yas also very thick and high. Now, let's take some more cases. When an alif mad is followed by a sukun. Like here you see wa, and then you have lam, and lam has sukun on it. Then the alif mad is dropped. Why? Because you see the graph there, alif mad is weaker compared to sukun there. So sukun is stronger, it will catch the attention. It will not allow you to give wal, like wal. No, and also the other way to look at it is sukun, the letter lam in this case has sukun, and sukun means it is hurt, it needs help. So you just help it. There's no time to say wal by the time that lam may die. So you got to help it fast. Wal, just neglect the mad. So let's take 10 such cases. First line, wal, was. So don't say wal or was. The mad is not, the alif mad is not pronounced here. The alif mad is not pronounced here. Don't say wal, just say wal. Because sukun, the letter with sukun needs help. You don't have time to say wa. Just go, run, rush. Wal, was, wa, wad, fas. Similarly, take the second line. Fan, fa. So don't say fan, fa, no, fan, fa, fal, bil, bis. In case of bil and bis, alif is not mad because before alif there is no fatha. But in this case also when you see alif, it is not pronounced because there's no sign on alif. I mean, alif doesn't have sign anyway, except when it becomes hamza. Alright, so bil and bis. That's it. Let's try to read those words that occur most frequently in the Quran. Try to read with me or at least repeat after me. Bal. Well, we learned most of these, but here they make meanings. Bal means rather. So lam is being helped by ba. Ba has to help lam. Bal. Bal. Man. Man means who? Man rabbuka. Who is your Rabb? That's the first question in the grave. Okay? And Mananta, who are you? Man means who? Am. An. Revise last four. Bal. Man. Am. An. If. It means when. Min. Min is from. Min. Too many times in the Quran. You see that? More than 2,000 times. Qul. Say. Many times in the Quran. Almost 300 times. Qul. Qul huwa Allahu ahad. Say. Qul. Qaf is high sounding. Hum. Hum is they. So let's revise the last four. Idh, min, qul, hum. Once again, idh, min, qul, hum. Take some more. Wa idh, wa idh, wa min, wa min. فَقُلْ فَقُلْ فَهُمْ فَهُمْ. So here the last letter is the one that has to be helped by the one before it. فَهُمْ. So let's revise. وَإِذْ وَمِنْ فَقُلْ فَهُمْ. Once again, وَإِذْ وَمِنْ فَقُلْ فَهُمْ. لَكُمْ لَكُمْ وَمَنْ. In all these cases, you see the letter with sukun is helped by the one before it. So man is helping, meem is helping noon, man. Wa has no effect. Wa man. Wa man. Bihim. Bihim. Awalam. So a wa has no effect of sukoon. Lam has to help the meme with the sukoon. Meme with sukoon on it. So awalam. Awalam. Revise the last four. Lakum. Waman. Bihim. Awalam. Lakum. Waman. Bihim. Awalam. Minhu. Minhu. Min means from. Who is him? From him. Minha. Minha. So the noon with sukoon is helped by min. Okay, the one before it. So min, and the rest you recite the way you know. So ha, minha. Similarly, til, just say til, and the ka will be as normal. Tilka. Tilka. Maryamu. So you say mar and yamu is normally recited. Maryamu. Ra is thick here. Maryamu. Don't say Maryam. Maryamu alayhi salam. Revise the last four. Minhu. Minha. Tilka. Maryamu. Once again. Minhu. Minha. Tilka. Maryamu. Minkum. Minkum. So here we have two words. The noun is suppressed here. You will learn this later on. You don't say minkum. You say minkum, like pink. Minkum. Minkum. Okay. Minhum. Noun is not suppressed here, just normally. Those rules will be clear later on. That was exception. Anyway, minhum. So you have min, one pair, and hum, another pair. Meme is helping noon in the first pair, and ha is helping meme in the second pair. Min hum. Min hum. Ma'akum. Ma'akum. Ma'ahum. Ma'a means with. Hum means they. Kum means you. And so on. You will be learning these in spoken Arabic also. Ma'ahum. Ma'ahum. Let's revise the last four. Minkum. Minhum. Ma'akum. Ma'ahum. Once again. Minkum. Minhum. Ma'akum. Ma'ahum. Okay, here we have some more combinations with big words, but you just split them, and whenever you see sukoon the following letter, just help it. So a, and then you have sukoon al, then mu, but you have sukoon there on lam. Mul. Al mulku. Al mulku. Alhamdu. 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 All praise. Alhamdulillah. An'amta. 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 Aslamtu. Aslamtu. See how easy it is. Just see, if you are having a letter with sukoon, you know, then just help it. So let's revise the last four. Al-mulku. Al-hamdu. An'amta. Aslamtu. Once again. Al-mulku. Al-hamdu. An'amta. Aslamtu. Here we have sukoon spread out. So after ba, we have sukoon. So ba. Then du. Hum. After ha, we have sukoon. So ba'duhum, see that? Ba'duhum tahtiha, tahtiha ta'lamuna. We have sukoon on waw there, but that waw is waw mad. Okay, so you got to stretch mu, mu, don't forget. So ta'lamuna. Waw mad is also, waw is kind of helped by, you know, meme, by stretching the sound mu. So now you know another logic of this waw mad. Ta'lamuna waja'alna. So waja is normal. Ayn is followed by, a is followed by lam sukun. So al. And na is, you know, alif mad is there. So waja'alna. Waja'alna. Let's revise the last four. Ba'duhum du is very thick and high. Ba'duhum. The right, you know, da. Tahtiha. تعلمون وجعلنا. Once again, بعضهم تحتها تعلمون وجعلنا. Let's play a word game. Can you find out the word من? The word من. The word من. The fourth one, man means who. Okay, man anta, who are you? Okay, where is the word minhum? Where is the word minhum? Minhum. The second one, mashallah. Where is the word bismi? Small one, can't be the first. Bismi. The last one, mashallah. Before we close, let's take spoken Arabic. You know, if you want to say no, that means la. Somebody asks you wrong question. Say, for example, ahua kafir? Is he a kafir? Kafir meaning the one who rejected faith. Not everybody is kafir. The one who understood Islam and rejected Islam, he is kafir. Otherwise, everybody in general is a non-Muslim. But anyway, so you say la. No, huwa Muslim. He is a Muslim. La, hum Muslimun. No, they are Muslims. La, anta Muslim. La, antum Muslimun. La, ana Muslim. La, nahnu Muslimun. Basically, la means no. Okay? La means no. Alright, by now you know how to recite the words that occur approximately 17,500 times. And also the meanings of words that occur approximately 15,500 times. So be an expert, watch this again and again, practice with flashbook, and pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbi Zidni Ilma. That's it for now. See you in the next lesson. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum. Learn to read Al-Quran, learn Tajweed, understand Al-Quran and memorize it using easy, scientific and interactive methods. Get ebooks, videos, audios, posters, PowerPoint files, app links for different courses. We have specialized Montessori materials and games for making the Quran easy for kids, and a teacher's resource center too. Get personalized one-to-one online courses that suit your needs from expert teachers. For free trial, write to admin@understandquran.com or visit understandquran.com. Wassalamu alaikum.